I got these feelings, I try to bear it down, but they keep screaming, and I'm just trying to filter out somehow, but they don't wanna leave. No, you don't need it, all the jealousy and ugly feelings left from my history. I try so hard, but they get the best of me. But you'd rather be next to me. All the voices in my head always try to break me. Fuck me up and change me. But talk is cheap. This is the last time I listen to the voices in my head. I know they never stop talking, always sabotaging. But talk is cheap. This is the last. Voices in my head always try to break me. Fuck me up and change me. But talk is cheap. This is the last time I listen to the voices in my head. I know they never stop talking, always sabotaging. But talk is cheap. This is the last time I listen to the voices in my head.
Hey world, it's Sunday now and I just took a shower, so I thought it's as good a time as any to give you a little wrap up on my weeding week. Let's just get right into it. You saw me weeding. You saw what I was planning to weed, so let's start with the things I didn't. Sadly, I didn't get to Wild and Wise by Dixie Wilts. This is basically like, yeah, I don't know if you could call it short stories. It's like things about animals that you didn't know yet. And it's really funny and the illustrations are gorgeous, but I already figured that I wouldn't get to it because it's not like a book that you can sit down and read in one go. So I'm hoping to just like the next couple of weeks, maybe just take it with me to work, like do a little bit of reading, like one page at a time. I also didn't get to Erebos by Ursula Poznanski. Sorry, friend who gave me this. You'll have to wait a bit longer to get this back. Now, the reason I wanted to read this was because the second part just came out and my friend is a huge fan of her, and now working at a bookstore, I know that a lot of other people are too. She seems like an amazing author and I wanted to give it a go, and I thought why not start with this now that the second part is out. If I like it, I can continue it. I just didn't start yet. Sadly, I also didn't get to this manga series, which is Let's Destroy the Idol Dream, which annoys me so much because I've already read the first one like 2 times and I really, really love it. And I was so excited about the second one, and the third one is coming out at the beginning of next year. And I really like this series, like the characters are so quirky and funny and they have amazing friendships. But the thing is, there's like, I think 7 or 8 of them and I just can't keep up. I can't remember who is who and like their secrets and like their goals and their character traits. I just can't remember all of it. So I wanted to reread the first one and take notes so that now going into the second one and then like 3 months from now with the third one, I haven't forgotten all of it. And I started, but I just, you know, taking notes while reading, it's just annoying. And I just keep putting it off. So yeah, at some point I'm gonna do this because I really love the series. The characters are wonderful. I highly recommend it. But for now, I haven't gotten to it yet. However, I did buy and borrow some other mangas, including Blue Flag Part 4, which I am so excited for. This is my favorite series at the moment. Blue Flag is super cute. It's so adorable. The friendship slash relationships in this are just pure gold. And when this came into the bookshop, I didn't even put it on the shelf for others to see it. I just bought it right away. It was just mine. I love this series so much. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take one day where I'm off work and just do a manga readathon. Maybe take a weekend and do a 24-hour thing, I don't know yet. But I'm gonna do a manga readathon at some point, and that's also when I'm gonna fit in this and finally get to it, because I wanna get on with the series. I did read one manga, which is Our Summer Holiday by Kaori Ozaki. I think I pronounced it right. It's so gorgeous. Like, look at this. It's just so pretty. It's one story, there's no follow-up, which I think is nice, and it was really surprising. It is still gorgeous, and it's also gorgeous in its storytelling, but it's also really heavy and hard-hitting and quite traumatic and dramatic and emotional and sad and, yeah, just too real at some points. So I had a really emotional time reading this. It was pretty shocking. Like, it still is a wonderful, wonderful manga, and I highly recommend it to anyone. Just be warned not to read it in public, maybe. Like, read it in a quiet moment with a cup of tea and tissues ready, because that's the kind of story you're getting into. And I didn't expect that, but I still loved it with my whole heart. It's so, yeah, it's just stunning in every way. Going on to my current read at the beginning of the video. Yeah, I'm not currently reading this anymore. It's Die Kieferninsel by Marion Poschmann. This is a German novel. And I'm gonna be honest, I bought it because of the cover and because it says Japan on the back, and I just like Asian stuff. It's really, really pretty. It started quite promisingly bizarre, and then it just got bizarre, bizarre. And I'm about 50 pages from the end, and I just stopped. I just don't want to spend any more time on this. I'm disappointed, and it's weirding me out, and I just don't care anymore. I'm not gonna finish this book. As pretty as it might be, and as much potential as it has, maybe I'm missing out on the last 50 pages, maybe they tie it all in and then it works. But I just don't want to spend the energy on reading it. I just didn't like it. What I did like very much, however, was Four Kisses by Garth Nix. Oh my god, this book is fantastic! You have to read this! So I picked this up at the library. Mostly because I love fairy tales and it just looked nice. And then I saw that it's by Garth Nix. And here's the thing with me and Garth Nix. Years ago, ages ago, I picked up a fourth part of one of his series, not realizing it was the fourth part. And I started reading it and pretty quickly realized that I've missed something. And then I realized it was the fourth part. I've missed three entire books. But that bit that I read was so cool, even if I didn't understand anything, that I really, really, really wanted to read the rest of the series. Now, I'm bad at buying books when they're not immediately in front of me. The list of books I've been dying to read for ages but just haven't gotten to yet because I'd have to order them and I'm too lazy to do that. Is, yeah, just let's not talk about that. However, since then I have stumbled upon the seventh part of the series, so now I have the fourth and the seventh, and recently a friend was kind enough to lend me the first part so that I could actually finally start the series. Haven't done that yet, will do that soon, especially now that I've read this. Because now I know for sure that I adore Garth Nix. Like, I already figured from the first bit I read from that fourth book, but now I know. His writing style is so witty and sarcastic and clever and yeah, just oh, it's so cool. Also, The Princess is fantastic. The quest is so funny and interesting and actually really like thrilling, and there's an overly excited dog. I mean, what more do you need than an overly excited, really cute, really happy, helpful dog? Yeah, just one of the best fairy tale retellings ever, and that's saying a lot since I read a lot of fairy tale retellings. Just, yeah, go for it. Read it. Love it. Oh, amazing. Then, on to these bad boys. So, I love the Spider-Man Deadpool series. I'm gonna tell you the backstory of how I got into these. And the backstory, in short, is Tumblr. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of either Spider-Man or Deadpool. no real reason, I just... It's not that I hate them or like I don't like them, it's just that I don't care about them as much as about other heroes. But then I kind of stumbled into the rabbit hole of Deadpool Spider-Man art on Tumblr, and people are just so talented and it's so pretty, and it kind of showed me this other side of them, and I wanted to know if that side was actually presented in the comics or if people were just really creative. So I picked up a comic, and as it turns out, it's bloody amazing. The first four parts were the ones I've already read a while back, and they were super interesting. I was so into them. The characters just work great together. They have such an amazing dynamic, and the portrayal of them is super interesting, because it's so different than anything you see in like movies and like the mainstream representation of them. You just see a side to them that you don't normally see. And yeah, they're just a really nice team. So these are parts 5 to 8. They're still really cool. I still really enjoy them as characters, and the story is progressing in a really interesting way. And their relationship is super cool, super interesting, all that stuff that's still there. However, there's a new character that's kind of getting in between them, and it's kind of messing up that dynamic that I loved so much in the first four parts. And I'm gonna continue the series because I want to see where it goes, and I'm guessing the character that's messing it up at the moment for me isn't gonna be there for the entire story. It's like kind of, it's the hurdle they have to get over to progress their relationship even further. So once they get over that, the character's gonna be gone. And I want to see what happens then. So I'm going to continue with the series. So yeah, it was still a really good read. It just wasn't as good as the first four parts. Then I did some reading for work. Basically, this is a collection of little snippets and like first chapters of the books that are nominated for the Deutscher Buchpreis, so the German book prize. It's like the biggest book prize of the year, and it's a super big deal, and as a bookseller I have to know about it to like recommend it and tell people about it when they're asking. So I just had to go through it and like read the first chapters of all these books that are nominated, and some of them are really good. Like some of them made my list of books I might want to read at some point. It's not really that interesting because I didn't actually read any real full books. I just thought I'd tell you that I also did that. I also took notes on this, you know, for like work stuff. So it took me a bit longer and it was like more of a reading exercise or something than actual reading for enjoyment. But yeah, read that as well. And that brings us to the last book, which is also work related because I got it from work. It's Oh My God, This Isling by Sarah Breen and Emma McLissell. I probably butchered this. It's all Irish. And I just finished it this morning. I'm not quite sure how to feel about it yet. You know, when you pick up a book and you have a certain view of it, a certain idea, a certain expectation, and then it's completely different? The thing is, the expectation I had wasn't just like my expectation, it's how the book is promoted. It's promoted to be hilarious and super funny and quirky and relatable. And it just wasn't. It was dramatic and sad and annoying. Like, the main character is the kind of girl you'd hate in real life because all she does is complain about her life. It just wasn't fun. And I kept reading because I thought, like, at some point it's gotta get funny. And it got better, but it didn't get funny. So yeah, I think if I didn't have that expectation brought upon me by the authors, the blurb, the presentation, the media around it, and if I started reading it without any of those expectations, I would have enjoyed it. But this way, I like started to enjoy it halfway through when I realized it wasn't gonna change, and I kind of just accepted it. There are some really interesting storylines in it and some pretty cool characters, but it's just not, yeah, it's not what it says it is, and I don't think I like what it is instead. So yeah, that's it. That's the stuff I read this week. I'm pretty proud of myself, and I also just enjoyed getting back into reading because at the moment I don't have that much time for it with work and all that stuff. And I just enjoyed, you know, just sitting down and getting lost in the fantastic worlds. As I said, I'm gonna try to do a manga readathon at some point. Don't quite know how that's gonna work yet and like what kind of format it's gonna be. But either way, I'm gonna film that as well, so look forward to that. And yeah, let me know some books you've read recently. Let me know some that are maybe like nice and easy to read. So something that I could read like when I don't have that much time or that much energy to get like into a heavy, really like book that needs brain to read. Let me know some recommendations and some thoughts on your recent reads in the comments down below. And I hope you always have a reason to smile, and I shall see you soon. Bye!